City Pulse is sponsored by CN Vision Image Consulting, Chi, an international focus magazine. Music provided by Houston's own Dynamic Sound. HTV supports local businesses.
Hi, and welcome to this edition of City Pulse, a show for the City of Houston by the City of Houston. The coronavirus pandemic has presented many global challenges. Wearing a face mask and maintaining a social distance of 6 feet was the new normal. Hand washing for more than 20 seconds became second nature. Changes in our daily routine and lifestyle have affected how we cover City Pulse here at Houston Television. Though COVID vaccines will hopefully change all that. Until then, one of our talented staff will voice the show as we deliver stories that impact us in our lives, work, and much more. Hurricane season is here, and preparation for heavy storms is very important. Thankfully, Houston's Office of Emergency Management has some helpful tips about the essentials we should have when the power goes out.
June 1st is the start of hurricane season. The City of Houston's Office of Emergency Management has already begun to prepare for the next big one by training all first responders and staff.
We are working to anticipate what this hurricane season might bring for us this year. So in preparation, we've started everything from looking at our evacuation plans to making sure our critical infrastructure has been reinforced, and then to make sure that our employees and first responders have been training to be ready to respond when that incident.
Nakia Bradley said after Hurricane Harvey dropped 52 inches of rain and crippled Bayou City, residents need to prepare a kit just in case.
We always should remember the three key areas: having a plan, knowing where you would go, having relatives out of state maybe you can stay with or that are nearby like Dallas or San Antonio. Also having a kit, your things in there like medications for at least the next month. Also having in that kit PPE, because it's still a COVID world out there, and having our mask and our sanitizer. Other things to remember are our pets. Making sure that we have food and water for our pets. Also for our younger ones, if you have children under 5 and having things like diapers and formula that is available. For our seniors, in addition to your medication, also having other things like blankets and flashlights.
It is extremely important to stay abreast of the latest information during the hurricane.
So you can call 211, which is State of Texas Emergency Assistance Registry. We usually give this number out for those who have function and access needs or need additional help with being able to evacuate or resources in an emergency.
Lessons learned from Hurricanes Harvey and Ike has made the city better prepared by creating a special response team.
Hurricane Harvey taught us some great lessons in terms of needing a bigger surge capacity to get around the city. Houston is the fourth largest city. So one of the things that we worked on this year was putting together the Houston Emergency Response Team. We pulled together Tier 2 and Tier 3 City of Houston employees to be a surge staff to our first responders.
Lastly, know your route of escape.
Right there.
If you decide to stay in place, make sure you have enough food and water to last 7 days. Mariana Villanguren, City Pulse.
When we come back, HTV participates in a ride-along as a council district offers a new approach to city policing.
Oh, well, thank you. Our children and families want us to be healthy. That's why I and lots of other grown-ups got the COVID-19 vaccine, so we can stay healthy and get back to the moments we miss, like seeing our friends and family.
Here you go, Daddy, for a healthy checkup, a sticker.
Oh, thanks, son.
With free COVID-19 vaccines, sunnier days are ahead. Visit getvaccineanswers.org.
Hey, boss. Okay.
Said I'm fine.
Call me the babe. See you in the morning. With the first deed, Superman, but it wasn't Arnie. And we lost it. In my head, in my head, in my head. We were underlay, in my head.
Hey, son.
Hey, Bob.
I know you can talk to me.
Yeah.
It's been difficult because I hadn't been able to see my grandchildren.
An expression on someone's face when you do something nice for them.
I miss all my friends in school.
Visit getvaccineanswers.org so you can make an informed decision about COVID-19 vaccine.
Hey world, I have a quick message. It's about safe driving. All right, let's go. Anytime you're driving, have the seatbelt buckle tight, both hands on the wheel, and your phone out of sight. When not in your hand trying to text somebody back, because if you do, your car might get smacked. The moral of the story, just put your phone down. The people on the road will stay safe and sound. Put your phone down, put your phone down. People on the road will stay safe and sound. Yeah.
Sorry about that. No, I've been staying at my dad's place because of everything.
Where are we going?
He's good. Yeah, I know, we keep missing each other. I've been working out of my dad's house, doing some reading. I should be working out more. I just feel like I'm drowning.
Navigating these times can be tough, but while you care for your loved one, you also need to care for yourself. Go to aarp.org/caregiving for free mental health and self-help tips.
Welcome back to City Pulse. HTV News Director Mariana Oyanguren participates in a ride-along with Councilmember Edward Pollard to see District J Patrol in action. His public safety initiative utilizes special vehicles allowing police officers and residents to interact candidly in the neighborhood.
Officer Ayala is using the latest HPD patrol vehicle in this Glenshire neighborhood to talk to residents who may have committed minor infractions. Councilmember Edward Pollard created the Patrol Unit Task Force in District J to have a presence, something he has worked on since his campaign.
When I was out on the campaign trail in 2019, public safety was our top priority. And so we wanted to come up with an idea that would involve the community in the safety of their own communities. What we came up with was the District J Patrol, which is the first of its kind community-led HPD patrol, where we have a task force of 10 people who live within District J.
I didn't see anything, but let's see if we can find it.
HTV did a ride along to see how these Houston police officers communicate with the community. As we rode through the neighborhood, we spoke with a resident who had his vehicle illegally parked in the yard.
Hi, how's it going?
So far, so good.
I'm Officer Ayala, no big deal.
Okay.
Hey, we noticed your car is parked on the yard right now.
Yeah.
Is it just because of the work being done?
Yeah, just because of it, but I'm going to move right now.
Okay, yeah, just because it is a violation to be parked on the yard.
Miguel thanked the officers for their hard work, especially since their lives are always on the line.
I'm respect their officers' life because they're always on the jeopardy.
A lot of people don't know that it's against city code to do that, so it's a lot of education with residents.
Bert Reese, chair of District J's Patrol Community Task Force, said these new patrol vehicles seem to work better because they're more approachable.
This is a great initiative. It's an opportunity to really engage community residents in partnership with HPD. It's a learning opportunity. So because of the vehicle, the way that it's designed, as they are patrolling the neighborhoods, it's very approachable. So there's opportunity for officers to directly engage with residents.
Councilmember Pollard said residents can place their complaints online.
So what we've seen is that people are going online to a portal, districtjpatrol.com, and that's where they're reporting their issues.
A resident flagged down the patrol unit to turn in a wallet that had recently been found. This is the kind of policing Councilmember Pollard and the Houston Police Department are striving for. Mariano Yanguren, City Pulse.
Before we go, Director Stephen Williams with the Houston Health Department presents HPD Chief Troy Finner with a special award.
Y'all know this got to be a real special occasion for me to come in the police department. And it is a special occasion because we wanted to recognize Chief Finner for a number of years. What we wanted to do is to really recognize you by giving you this Youth Violence Prevention Coalition recognition.
That does it for City Pulse. Thank you for watching HTV, your story, your voice, your station.